One of the issues that confronts beginner coaches and indeed beginner athletes, particularly in the younger age brackets when they start to coach or start to row, is understanding the basics of the stroke and getting the right grip to start with. So when they're looking to grip a sculling oar, want to hang on to it the right way and feather it the right way rather than with the cocking of the wrist, which causes issues later on. In our experience, it's been that particular habits are the hardest ones to break when they're learnt early. For example, feathering the blade incorrectly is a really difficult habit to break once it's been learnt. Being able to row without breaking the arms at the catch is another typical one. Rowing in a tall posture is another one. And so what we put together here is 5 minutes of video, so anyone who's starting out would have time to watch it. And we've got two pieces of video. The first one is a video of an athlete rowing what we consider to be a pretty good precise stroke with commentary over the top explaining the various aspects of the stroke. And the second one is Anthony Edwards demonstrating how to hang on to a sculling blade the correct way and how to feather it without creating those bad habits. So I think any beginner coach or any beginner athlete, if they watch these two pieces of video, then they'll have a really good understanding of what's required in order to coach crews so they get the right habits from the start and don't end up building those bad habits that then take years to correct. So enjoy them, and of course more information on how to correct bad habits and the like and how to coach further is available on the Decent Rowing website. So thanks and enjoy the videos. In this particular piece of footage, we are looking to demonstrate the correct posture throughout the stroke. With this athlete, you will note at the finish she's sitting tall and with her chin up. As she taps out and moves the hands away from the body, the shoulders remain behind. Then she commences to rock over with the pelvis moving first and the shoulders following. Softening the knees and the toes will assist by easing pressure on the hamstrings. As she allows the boat to run underneath her and moves towards the catch, she maintains a tall position in the boat. When the handle moves over her toes, then she lifts the handle and thereby placing the blade in the water, then reverses direction and drives backwards through the hips without lifting the shoulders or flexing the arms. As the body moves towards vertical, i.e. after about half of the slide has been extended, then the arms begin to contract and move towards the finish. As the arms finish the stroke off, you'll note that the blade is still fully buried in the water right to the finish. Then there's a clean tap out and we commence the same cycle again. It is very important to maintain the right pelvic control during this process, with the pelvis being vertical as often as possible. Allowing the pelvis to slump will reduce the effectiveness of the posture and can lead to bad backs and poor performance.
One of the key things that you see a lot of, is which is incorrect, is people holding on to a skull or hanging on to their out here, or they're really tight and there. And if we hold them really tight, tend to be cocked up wrist, tight there. The right way to hold a sculling grip, if you think, hands across the palm, goes on the top just there. Thumb is always on the end. The hand wraps around. What you should find is there's a 90 degree angle just here, off the knuckle, top there, and the thumb obviously on the end. When the skull is going along, you should feel the grip there in the hand. And you should also be feeling it in his fingers. Just down through here, right on the tips of the fingers. So with that 90 degree arc, the sculler should be able to come through to the finish. As he comes to the finish, he can just release. Notice the flat wrist, not the cocked wrist, like such. All right, so if you can see, when I come out square and feather in the finish position, I would roll out. I'm feeling it in the tips of my fingers. You can see that 90 degree arc off the finger there. All right, the grip's in my palm. If feeling at the tips of my fingers. Now by doing that, when the sculler comes to the finish position, he's able to hold himself nice and strong. Feather there, flat wrist, elbows are up, away it goes. In the other way, when someone's got a tight grip, you'll notice the cocked wrist, and the only way to finish there is to turn like that, and what actually happens, the angle and the force of slump, and the elbows are pointing down. So in particular the wrist, the elbow, the hips have sunk into the boat. That's an incorrect finish, and the hand grip can be an impact for that. So we're looking at hand grip, around, feeling the fingers, nice strong position at the back. Nice strong through here, elbows up, flat wrist.
I hope that you enjoyed those videos and that they provide you good information going forward. We do have on the website a chart of that well-executed rowing stroke that I'd commend you all to download and blow it up to A3 size and put it on the wall of the rowing shed, because it's a really good way for the beginner athletes to connect with the video and to connect with what we're trying to achieve. So, good coaching, and thanks for watching.